overall pick. And imagine if you're Alexis Lafreniere. You're all mic'd up. You're all ready to go. You think you're going to find out where you're going. Well, not yet. So we will have to wait and see who gets the number one overall pick. And that'll take place probably sometime in early August, correct?
Yes, when you talk about the in-between. Once that qualifying round is over, before the playoffs begin. Yeah. This was the moment Bill Daly announcing the number one pick.
The number one overall selection in the 2020 NHL draft belongs to a team yet to be determined coming from the qualifying round in the Stanley Cup playoffs.
When you lose on a game show, typically you get the Dirt Devil by Royal and a home version of the game. When you lose in the qualifying round, if you're one of those eight teams, 12.5% chance to draft Alexis Lafreniere, and that's big time. This will take place, as EJ mentioned, between the qualifying round and the first round. So, here we go. The remaining teams, once that phase two is held, will go in the reverse order of their points percentage. So, anticlimactic in some senses, but I think of Willy Wonka or Willy O'Ree, who said, the suspense is killing me, I hope it lasts.
Yeah.
So now we're going to have this last. Think about how good a team, let's say, and there was a lot of discussion about the Pittsburgh Penguins. Mm-hmm. Tough opening round. What if they lose and they get Alexis Lafreniere? That would be unreal.
Yeah, I think there'd be a lot of people that wouldn't be all that happy about that scenario unfolding. But listen, for those watching, you know, obviously watching us at home, you know, you think about this, and there'll be a lot of people that say, boy, oh boy, this is not really great, because teams, there's a little bit of an incentive if you fall behind in the series, maybe just to call it quits in the series. A team that is a team that's done very well, maybe in the standings, all of a sudden could end up with the first overall pick in the draft. But we are in a very unusual circumstance.
True.
We knew this was a possibility. This is not by any means a perfect world we are living in for a lot of reasons right now.
Well said.
And so it has unfolded this way. There wasn't a big chance that this could happen, but there was a chance.
I like that you brought up the numbers. The chance, 2.5%.
Wow.
The team that was drawn, Team E, 2.5%. Ottawa felt good about its chances, 25%. And when people talk about throughout the course of the year, are teams trying to win, you'll never convince me that any hockey player or coach doesn't want to do anything but win.
Yeah.
And that, too, will come up. Obviously, we joked around about the consolation prize. The Erik Karlsson trade, coupled with Ottawa's finish, had them at 25%. The Kings, 9.5%. They're going to draft second.
Yeah.
They had the two cups in 3 years. You've got to believe that, and you've said that there's about a dozen players that could help right away. This accelerates their turnaround.
Yeah, it's terrific for the LA Kings because they will have that second pick. Most likely Lafreniere will go first, and they will have their choice of several other players. And Tony, talking to scouts and people who've really gone through this draft class, they tell me that 12 or 13 players, as many as 12 or 13 players, really high-quality players that are available at the top of this draft. We're talking about a starting goaltender, a top-pair defenseman, and first-line talent. So that's a lot of guys to choose from. So it's a little bit of a consolation for some of these teams that didn't get that first, second, third pick that kind of fell down the ladder. There are a lot of good players out there. And one other thing I want to throw out about the lottery in the National Hockey League over the last couple of years, 2017, Philly moves from 13 to 2.
Good point.
2018, Carolina from 11 to 2. 2019, Chicago from 12 to 3. So we've seen with the NHL lottery, we've seen these kind of jumps before. This is just kind of a crazy circumstance this year with a very different scenario. And so, as everything that has happened in 2020, here we go again.
Unusual indeed. This will be something that, and you mentioned Lafreniere going first.
Yeah.
This player, for those that aren't as familiar, I think back to the World Juniors, Team USA and Canada. 6-4 was the final score. They met in pool play. 1-3. He went into that tournament with so much scrutiny, so much attention, and boy, did he deliver with the brightest lights on the biggest stage.
Yeah, I mean, he's a terrific talent. There's no question about that. Talking again, different scouts. One of the comparisons I hear is Mikko Rantanen. That's a pretty good player,
yeah.
A really high-end player. Not a center, but a winger. But you're right, he was a force at the World Juniors. And remember, he got hurt.
Yes.
And it looked like he was going to be out of the mix, and he was able to come back and play. So that was something else that he showed, that ability to play through injury and get there. So it will be interesting to see how things obviously unfold at the top. But after that, what L.A. decides to do and right on down the line from there, because there's some interesting choices amongst the players, you know, the German Stutzla.
Yes, Stutzla.
Stutzla.
Tim.
There you go.
Yes.
Is a really high-end player, a guy that could be looked upon as kind of a Patrick Kane type winger, really can distribute and make things happen. That's a guy that could be there. Quentin Byfield, big centerman. So there's some choices for the L.A. Kings.
And along the lines of comparisons, Quentin Byfield has drawn comparisons to Anže Kopitar, a name that warms the hearts of Kings fans. Let's welcome in from the Los Angeles Kings. Everybody's always talking about you got to go high in the draft. Not always. Lucky Luke Robitaille, one guy believed in him. Your Hall of Fame speech, one of the all-time best. Now, here you are. Your team is going to draft second. What was your immediate reaction, you and Rob Blake, when you saw the announcement?
Well, we were trying to figure out the whole process, but certainly when we saw that it started going down and the way they announced it, I think we looked at each other. We think we're in the top three. Then we heard, I think it was Catherine,
okay.
She said we were in the top three. So,
you guys, I figured it out. It's going to be one of the teams in the qualifying playoff round to get that Lafreniere guy. So there's basically a chance, a 50-50 chance that the Penguins get Lafreniere. What the hell is wrong with the NHL right now? See, the Penguins have a better chance now of getting Lafreniere more than the Red Wings, the Senators, the Ducks, the Kings, the Devils, and the Sabres. How the hell does that make sense? Even more work to do. Comment down below